We are asked to describe the transformation of the identity function f of x equals x given g of x equals 2/3 x minus 3. Notice how the function g of x is a linear function in slope-intercept form, which is the form f of x equals mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the vertical intercept. So in this case, we have a line with a vertical intercept of negative 3 and a slope of positive 2/3. But instead of using this information to graph g of x, in this lesson we will graph the function g of x based upon a transformation to the identity function f of x equals x. So to graph a linear function in the form f of x equals mx plus b by using a transformation of the identity function, step 1, we graph the identity function f of x equals x. Step 2, we vertically stretch or compress the graph by a factor of the absolute value of m. If the absolute value of m is less than 1, the line is vertically compressed. If the absolute value of m is greater than 1, the line is vertically stretched. And if m is less than 0, the graph is reflected across the x-axis. And then finally, we shift the graph up or down b units. So going back to our first example, m is equal to 2/3. So to describe the transformation, let's first determine the absolute value of 2/3, which equals 2/3. Because this is less than 1, we know g of x is compressed by a factor of 2/3 when compared to the identity function. So let's go ahead and say g of x is compressed by a factor of 2/3. Because m is positive 2/3, there is no reflection across the x-axis. Now notice b equals negative 3, which means g of x is also shifted down 3 units. Now let's graph g of x based upon this transformation of the identity function f of x equals x, which is already graphed. Let's begin by selecting 3 key points on the identity function. Let's select the origin, which would be the ordered pair 0, 0. Let's select the point 3, 3, this point here. Let's also select the point 6, 6, this point here. If we want to vertically compress this graph by a factor of 2/3, we would multiply the function values, or y values, by 2/3. So looking at the y values of these 3 points, we will multiply these values by 2/3, which will give us the y values of the graph that is compressed by a factor of 2/3. Well, of course, 0 times 2/3 is 0. So if we compress this graph by a factor of 2/3, it will still pass through the origin, this point here. 3 times 2/3 is equal to 6/3 or 2, which means for the compressed graph, when the input or x value is 3, the output or y value is 2, this point here. And now looking at the point 6, 6, 6 times 2/3 is 12/3, which equals 4, which means if the graph is compressed by a factor of 2/3, when the input or x value is 6, the output or y value is 4. So if we compress this graph by a factor of 2/3, it will pass through these 3 points and would look like this. This is not the graph of g of x because g of x is also shifted down 3 units. So to complete the graph of g of x, we will take these 3 key points on the compressed graph and shift them down 3 units. If we shift this point down 3 units, we'd be at the point 0, -3. If we shift this point down 3 units, we'd be at the point 3, -1. If we shift this point down 3 units, we'd be at the point 6, 1, this point here. So this blue line is a graph of g of x. To check this, notice how b equals negative 3, which gives us a vertical intercept. If we move from the vertical intercept to this point here, we go up 2 units and right 3 units, verifying the slope is positive 2/3. I hope you found this helpful.